Niall Ó Donnghaile is Belfast's youngest ever Lord Mayor. I'm here in the Lord Mayor's parlour to talk to him today.
What are your powers and responsibilities as Lord Mayor?
Probably more responsibilities than powers. Primarily the role of Mayor is a ceremonial one. There's no real, I suppose, executive power other than the actual formal chairing of the council meetings. Ceremonially, obviously, you have a civic responsibility. You have a responsibility in terms of representing Belfast, representing the people of Belfast. But I find that, and from a political point of view, the role of the mayor is useful in the sense that it's a good convener. You know, it's a good way to bring the necessary people around the table if needs be. And that was proven to me during the sort of last outbreak of violence in East Belfast. When as mayor, I pulled together a cross statutory meeting to try and respond to some of the problems that were presented as a result of that violence. I brought together the PSNI, the fire service, ourselves in the council, Department of Justice, OFM, DFM, Youth Justice Agency, Housing Executive, all of these groups come around the table. So I have found that when a mayor wants to utilise the position proactively, he or she can do it.
You're Belfast's youngest ever Lord Mayor. Do you feel equipped to take on the responsibilities in the position?
Yeah, I feel equipped. I do appreciate that there's sometimes this can be a bit tongue-in-cheek, this whole stuff and the sort of slagging I got in the chamber the night of my election. But I was just come from an event there talking to young people involved in youth work and I mean, at the same time too, there are people who have genuine concerns. There are people who were genuinely in private concerned. Was I able to do the job? I feel I'm able to do it. I'm sure the people who elected me feel that I'm able to do it. I know, and I'm very, very pleased that Sinn Féin think I can do it. And what I asked the night I was elected of those people who were criticising the choice was, you know, come back to me in a year and make a judgment after the year.
Yeah. The images of the riots were obviously big in the media. What would you say to the young people affected in these areas?
It's difficult because I suppose I live in and represent an area that's affected by what's sort of commonly called, you know, interface violence and stuff. I think a lot of it, and my experience of a lot of it, is more over recent years, low level, low key. Probably more antisocial. Mm-hmm. Now, I know that contrasts with what we've seen in recent weeks over the summer, and in particular with what we've seen in East Belfast, given the circumstances and those responsible. But, I mean, I think there needs to be a realisation. There also needs to be, I think, a focus on young people more generally, because I know, and I'm only using it, I'm not even talking for a minute as mayor or even as a councillor, just as someone who lives in East Belfast, I know and can say, you know, without hesitation, without qualification, that, for example, the local youth club, night in and night out, has 150 kids in it, playing football, playing pool, taking part in projects, doing cross-community work. It's half a dozen young people that are standing on the interface on both sides that are causing the trouble and bringing all that focus and that attention. You know, there's a powerful amount of positive work going on across this city, which more often than not people either don't hear about or maybe some media outlets are reluctant to tell.
Young people in WIMPS are interested in politics. Could you tell us about your journey to how you got here today?
You grow up in an area like the Short Strand and you inevitably question why there are walls around you. You know, why are they there? Should they be there? Do they need to be there? Do we want them there? What would happen if they came away? And all of those questions tend to lead you into politics, because I am of a view that everything is political. But in terms of party politics in East Belfast, I suppose I wasn't going to go into any other party, only Sinn Féin, because from my perspective and in the area that I lived in, they were the only outlet for someone involved in politics, for someone who was interested to get involved in party politics. So for me it was almost a natural step. But I was appointed the party's sort of representative spokesperson type position in East Belfast in around 2006 and stood for the assembly election in 2007. also stood in again in the Westminster election, and then in the council election this time around, and was successful. And I'm only the second ever Sinn Féin councillor in East Belfast. The first was Joe Donnell, who was elected from 2001 to 2005. So it's big stuff. And then obviously in terms of coming into the council, it's been a fairly rapid raise into this position. You know, I can only go downhill from here. But you know, I've been involved in political activism, community activism for quite some considerable time, and I'm more than confident, without being cocky, that I'm able to come into a place like this and go toe to toe with someone who's been about City Hall for decades.
Some young people are turned off by party politics, so what would your advice be to these people? How would they go about still being involved in the decisions for their community?
Well, the only way to change party politics is to be in it. And some things that can be done that can be intimidating for young people to go into an established political party, especially with people that have been about a long time. But that's not always the case. And I think young people bring change and bring a contribution to any organisation, and that includes a political party. But the only way to implement change is to get in there and get involved and do it, whether it's inside of a political party or outside of a political party. It's to get active and to lobby, to work. But also to be realistic about what you can do. And that's not to sort of dampen anybody's aspirations or goals, but it's to be realistic about what you can achieve and how you go about achieving it. And one thing that I've found from coming into the council too is identifying the right people to speak to. Because it's not always councillors or MLAs or any kind of elected representatives. Sometimes it's officers in here. You know how many young people know who the head of the Parks and Leisure Department is in the City Council? Because ultimately that's the guy I'm going to go to. If a young person comes and lobbies me about a skate park or about an issue that's affecting them and is in the park that they're using, that's who I'm going to go to. You know, so it's about identifying those key people as well and getting involved and making sure you're robbing all of the right doors.
Okay. Do you give us an interesting fact about being Lord Mayor?
One fact I didn't know was that the Mayor of Belfast has his own specific seat in St. Anne's Cathedral, which I didn't discover until I attended the graduation ceremony of the Belfast Bible College. Very happy that I had my own dedicated seat because it was cushioned and the ceremony went on for some time. So I was able to relax and enjoy it.
All right, thank you.
Thanks, Niamh. Thank you.
For talking to us.